In this session, I am going to discuss the topic of IoT, examples of IoT, especially we are looking here, right? And the challenges will be discussed in the subsequent slide, right? So, session 3, it is a part of the module 1, the Internet of Things application for 8th semester, Computer Science and Engineering. Here we can see the milestones of the presentation flow of this video lecture. We will commence with the examples of IoT. Of course, this is a continuation of the previous session, that is a session 1 dedicated to the fractional part of the introduction of the IoT, and session 2 encompasses the examples, right? So continuation of that, the other type of examples or applications of this IoT, we will go to be discussed in length in this session. Especially, one such application of the IoT is a city automation, right? City automation, so in the modern era, most of the cities, smart cities, because of the development of the science and technology, especially this IoT concept, so that is going to be extended in most of the city, what are the elements which are become a part of the city, maybe roads, maybe factory, maybe some buildings, maybe some the houses, right? There may be some security aspects. So, all those will be inclusion in the city automation. Let me see. So, automotive one is also the most important one, right? Automotive one. So, the mobile vehicles, right? So, the vehicles we can track of the, especially fleet management. So, owner of the vehicle, he can identify the where the vehicles are moving, what their status, and what is that, in which speed the vehicles are going, and what are all the goods are transporting, whether they are secured, so on, kind of things we can go to be see through these examples. Home automation, especially we have discussed that city automation. So, home automation, city comprises many component. One such component is a home automation, so that most of the human beings are utilizing that benefit of this IoT concepts, especially smart homes, right? Smart homes. So, smart cards, right? The most of the today's cards are very smart, ATM card, debit card, or the permission card. Those cards we can swipe there and we can get a permission or we can do some transaction too. The let me see in detail of this city automation. So that is some of the application. The traffic flow management system in a combination with the dynamics traffic light control. Traffic flow management, nowadays it is a very hot topic because the urban population is increasing. Similarly, urban number of vehicles in a urban is going to be enhanced. Is going to be more number every year, every month also, right? So those we need to be control systematically so that this traffic lights, the dynamic traffic lights is quite essential that. And also, the city comprises the street light control, street light. Street light will able to on and off automatically based on the temperature, based on the various environmental impacts. So that we can save the power to the maximum extent. It may be quite useful for the service provider as well as the customer. The passenger information system today is most important. So, there is a public transportation system. So the passengers are arrived to the station, they depart. So that information, they might travel, they might be connecting trains or connecting flights. There might be they cancel those kind of passenger information is quite important for transportation industry, today's industry. So the passive surveillance, right? So there is a surveillance is also impact over the today's city automation. So especially that passive surveillance also compare with the active surveillance. So passive surveillance that especially healthcare, public healthcare. So that diseases are reported by healthcare providers, right? So these kind of health the diseases are possible for various natural disturbance or calamity. So that the healthcare providers, they will be informed to the customer or users of that healthcare system. And active one, health agency contact health providers seeking reports, right? The agency will contact to the providers. So they will ask the reports, and based on the reports, they might go for medicine, they might go for discount, they might go for the enhancing their the office work and softwares, so on that is. The simple and inexpensive, that passive surveillance is very simple, and it is a lesser cost, and ensure more complete reporting of conditions. The more complete reporting of conditions will be available in the active surveillance, limited by incompleteness of reporting and the variability of quality. The passive surveillance will be by the healthcare providers, no? So that will be limited, it is an incomplete one. Whereas the active one, used in conjunction with the specific epidemiologic investigation, right? So that might be pandemic, or it may be microscopic, or it may be community, seasonal, right? So those are reports will be considered there. So coming to this anyhow, so those are the components we are going to be seeing applications. So especially that city automation, we have that we can see that so vehicles are moving, they are connected to the building, and those buildings are connected to the other component via the internet, and there is several other buildings they connected to society and health and telephone exchange, and they are also connected to the various other homes, right? And also connected to some industry, right? So these are all connected to that altogether form a smart city, right? Today smart city, that is a benefit of the or tremendous growth of the IoT is going to be helpful to become a smart city in most of the countries. City automation. So generic city sensors includes environmental sensors, activity sensors, environmental sensors and activity sensors. So that environmental sensors could include that is a thermal sensor. It measures the temperature, heat, hygrometric, anemometric, sound, gas particles, the dust particles, so atmosphere, the disturbance or pollution, can light, other EM spectrum, seismic data, that earthquake happen, that the what is a Richter scale of that earthquake happen, so that can be measured, and it can be transport to the satellite, so to the ground station, that environmental sensors, that most of the generic generalized city sensors will be comprises. The other part will be what is called activity sensors, which includes pavement or roadway pressures, right? So roadway, the how many vehicles are moving, so what is the weight of the vehicle, what is the length of the vehicle, what is the speed of the vehicle, so that roadways pressure can be activity sensors can include, can gauge. Vehicle and pedestrian detection, So the pedestrians in the signal or maybe in the moving road. So that is a pedestrian detection as a activity sensors based. Parking space occupancy. So that is a space will be zigzag manner parking, it will be occupied in hazardous way. So that will be it disturbs to the others. So that occupancy we can measure with help of the occupancy sensors. So that parking space is a most important component. So these are the basic broad category of sensors will be involved in most of the generic city automation. So especially generic city sensors we can call it as. So these sensors play an important role in most of the IoT concept that is. So here further we can move toward that concept to discuss that. There is a one example you can see that. There is a smart city. Smart city. So smart city means we can take a hospital. So that hospital have the patients and the patients will come by ambulance. So that ambulance that connected. So that intelligent medical device, so that in the ambulance itself they will be study the parameters, various parameters of the patient. So that can be transported to the head hospital, central hospital. So they will guide them to the driver or some of the device which are equipped there in the constraints way. So they can help the patient to the possible extent in an intelligent way. So things we can see smart automation. So that is also smart highway. So that highway can decide the speed of the vehicle, where that currently vehicles are there, what is their speed, and digital signage will be network optimization concept will be exercised, and it will be contacted to the central one. There is a smart factory in a city, smart factory. So that automatic car systems will be there, vehicles will be there, connected traffic cameras will be there, right? So that factory may be interface with outside the world or inside the world also, inside the factory also, so they can talk each other. And all this will be there also stadiums. Stadiums are there. So this stadium can be telecast their information, and they have integrated operation center, and also the power grid, smart grids, right? So smart grids will be supplied to the power, so they can also involve this in the city automation via IoT. There is a hospital optimization. As we take an example of hospital, no? Smart hospital, so that communication will be hospital optimization through the communication. So there is a energy management in a city related, so that energy we need to be receive and distribute, and we need to be manage up traffic flow optimization, right? So that part of the city, factory optimization, logistic optimization, supply chain and logistic of that various goods and all those, we can see that. And all this will be connected to the cloud and services based on the platform, so they will provide. So this is a simple the picture which indicates the city automation with the help of all these the examples. So city automation, so that traffic report, that is a M2M, one of the European model, use cases of M2M applications for city automation. It gives these applications. So the case one, that traffic flow management system in a combination with the dynamic traffic light control. Second case is the street light control. Third one is a passenger information, that public transportation passenger. So traffic flow, light, street light and passenger information. So these three case studies they have taken and made a standard report of this M2M. They come up with the standard rules. So that is by ETSI effort. City automation, that use case one, that is a traffic flow management combination with the dynamic traffic lights. So flow of road traffic within a city, it depends on the various factors, right? So factors are how many vehicles are on the road, right? So how long they will be there, and what is the day and time, right? So what is the current and expected weather, traffic issues, is there any traffic issues are there, in any blocks of the traffics, so accident, as well as road construction work, right? So these are all the factors they are going to be considered to decide that dynamic traffic light control. So similarly, the management system. So traffic flow management system can be developed that on real time also, real time that is actually needed. Optimization strategies, and thus endeavor to control the traffic flow that is. So traffic control can be achieved by the dynamic information display informing the driver about jams, traffic jams and congestion of the road. So this information gained by this IoT and is a part of the dynamic traffic light control can be possible with the help of this oftenly updating that information to the driver so that he can take the decision and he can go for the other alternative routed path to reach the destination. Traffic signs can direct the traffic to utilize the less used roads, right? So some alternative roads are there. So via those roads he can use for the their journey, their reach the destination. Flow management can also interact with the controllable traffic lights to extend or to reduce the green light period, to increase the vehicle throughput on a heavy use roads, right? Heavy use roads can be avoided here. So dynamically, changeable traffic signs can lead to an environment where the vehicle traffic is managed more efficiently, and this changeable traffic signs can help us to improve the efficiency. This enables cities to reduce the fuel consumption, air pollution, congestions, and huge amount of time spent on the road can be reduced also. So city automation, that case two, that is a street light control, that are not required to shine at the same intensity of complex to accomplish the intended safety goals, right? So depends upon the sunlight. So light can vary their intensity of the glowing. So the intensity of light depends on the conditions such as moonlight, weather, so on. That is, adjusting the intensity helps to reduce the energy consumption, also cost incurred by these local municipalities, right? So they can reduce to the smaller extent. Also, this controller, each street light segment is connected wired or wirelessly with the central street light managing and control system. See, the control system can dim the corresponding street lights of a segment remotely, or is able to switch street lights on and off, right? On and off. So city automation case 3, that is a public transportation passenger information. The public transport vehicles, bus, taxi or subway, the commuter trains, operate on a schedule that may be impacted by external variables, right? So, and thus have a degree of variability compared with the baseline formal schedule. It is vary with the schedule, previous the adapted schedule. So passenger need to know when their next connection is available. This kind of information the passenger can if know well, then have alternative connections in case of the delays happen. So such applications need current locations of the public transport vehicle provided to the central system is able to compare with the current location and the forecast the at each time or specific checkpoints, so that oftenly it precisely decide the estimated time for that corresponding passengers. Also compute the current delay and expected arrival time at the upcoming stops. The vehicle current location can be tracked via GPRS tracking devices that provide the position information in a regular interval. So the continuation of this K3 as a public transport passenger information, which helps to the both the service provider and the customer. So that can be achieved in the two possible way. So the first way, that is a checkpoint based. So checkpoint based approach, the line number of the bus or the streetcar is acquired at each station when the vehicle stops regularly or at defined checkpoints in between. So because of this because of the fact that sensors at a specific station is able to provide the data to main system, the expected delay can be computed by comparing the information of scheduled arrival time and actual arrival time. So based on this the arrival of fixed or decided or obtained, so he can compute the some vital information to the customer can able to provide. This change can add to arrival time displayed at each following station. So the station have single station or the long stations. So the some stations are very lengthwise. So in there in that system it require multiple that. Each vehicle must be equipped with a transponder variously based on the infrared radio frequency identification, short range communication, sometimes optical recognition too. In addition, each station has equipped with the one or more checkpoint system that are able to read out or receive the line number information of the vehicle. So if the station is a bigger one, so there required a more number of checkpoints. So in case larger station with several platforms need a multiple systems. Continuation of that, the second approach to that is a GPS and GPRS based. So each vehicle has to be equipped with the GPS, which track the vehicle. So besides the current position and the information that can be directly indirectly matched to the service line number based on the regular position, the system is able to devise actual time difference, that is arrival and expected time. So that can be displayed. So combination of checkpoint and GPRS based solution can be integrated rail vehicles such as subway, street cars, road vehicles, which be a robust one. The hybrid technique has evolved. So coming to this automotive applications, which as a part of this application of the IoT, Internet of Things concepts. So most of this M2M machine to machine automotive and transportation applications focusing that navigation, safety and security, and can interact with other vehicle and their insurance and toll of this roads, so fleet management, so the electric charge can manage their power, these typical applications entail I2M, M2M communication modules that are embedded into car or any the moving vehicle which are used for the public transportation or any other purpose. So continuation that vehicular asset tracking. So vehicular tracking, vehicles are moving on the road which is away from that the owner office. So those assets we can track, so those connected to the GPS. So in turn those GPS connected to the network, and that network, telecom networks, which help us to satellite that, and it gives to the information to owner of that vehicle. So the fleet owner wish to track the vehicle, so that is know to know over the time the location and what is the speed of the vehicle in order to plan and optimize the business operations. So they can guide remotely for the drivers of the vehicle if they know this kind of information, and the assets, the value of the assets can be maintained. A fleet of vehicle have been deployed with a machine to machine device installed which are able to perform sensors interfacing on the vehicle that measure the velocity and also detect the position where they are. So establish a link with the mobile telecommunication network using the network credentials, access credentials. So that universal subscriber identity model which helps to identify that most of the vehicles. Server that is a employee on behalf of the owner receives the and aggregates the process of tracking data, and fleet provides this information to the fleet owner in the real scenario, in the real world, right? So which is understandable format of that one format. So device could be configured to automatically establish the communication with the server via cellular networks at regular interval. At pre-scheduled time or based on some events such as crossing a geographic threshold, right? So that can also inform that is. So the alternatively, this M2M device could be commanded by M2M server of that to report their location velocity data. So that vehicular vehicle to infrastructure communication of this automotive application of the part of the IoT. So that is a mobile network and vehicle to vehicle communication. Neighboring vehicle or vehicle on the road, they can communicate, they can interact through this mobile network. So this will be connected to the server, that is a traffic information. So continuation of that, so European intelligent transport system directive seeks to implementation of electronic safety applications in a vehicle. So some vehicle manufacturers have deployed vehicle to vehicle communication. For example, General Motors, BMW, some of the leading vehicle manufacturers, so they have adopted this kind of vehicle to infrastructure communication. So example, context of the wireless access in a vehicle environments, that is WAVE. In other words, so vehicles to roadside applications are less well developed. In such case, vehicles have embedded the M2M devices which can interface with the location determinist technology and communicate to the other vehicle or server via this telecommunication network. So some vehicle infrastructure has deployed in most of the manufacturers. The vehicles have been deployed with this machine to machine devices installed that are to interface with the sensors on the vehicle, which measures the velocity and other external impacts. Establish a link with the mobile telecommunication networks using appropriate network access credentials, such as USIM. So download and upload the traffic safety information to the information server. So device could be configured to establish a communication along with the triggered by the vehicle sensors, such as external impact, motor failure, so on that is. So example, the traffic information server push roadside or emergency information out to vehicle based on a location, or vehicle information pushed to the traffic information server based on the external and internal sensor informations. So that vehicle information and also maybe sensor information. So after discussing this automotive example applications of this IoT, so quite interesting. One is home automation as a part of the city automation. So this machine to machine communication is expected to play a very vital role in most of the residential area, where the instrumentation of elements supporting daily living appliances, so that we have that lighting control, thermostat, so white goods, appliance control, in-home displays, right? So control applications include in that sense, and also security aspects. Security, so door access phone, window locks, motion detector, smoke fire alert, baby monitors, medical pendant. So these are the home security the issues, home security related one, which we need to be incorporated in a IoT network. So with help of their identity, so which have sensors or things which have identity. So one example for home automation with the home layout of the house. So single bedroom maybe. So we have bedroom, living room, family room, so utility room, and the other bathroom, kitchen, so on that dining room. So let we see. What are all the interfacing and IoT related things going to be established here? See, central part is a gateway, which help to establish the communication among most of the devices which are installed in a typical house, right? So there is a Digbee communication, Modbus, and etc. That is a heat or light control, so that maybe that occupancy sensors, right? So these are connected, which are placed in that living room. So we have it connected to the bedroom. So that is a electricity meter, so that is connected. So power consumption and all those information will be go to the gateway. So that it helps to the electricity supplier, so he can access the data connected to that. Water meter, that also municipality or water board can access the data. Based on that, they can send the bills of the consumer. Gas meter, so that is there is a gas pipeline for most of the urban city. So it goes to the via gateway, it connected to the kitchen. So the how much amount of gas they utilize, based on that bill will be decided. And again, it gas provider organization, that will be get an information. So also there is a other components, that electrical vehicle charging point, so charging station will be there. So there is a smart meters will be there. So there is also receiving transmitting data concentrator will be there. So this also connected to the heat meter and media, tablet, laptop, and all those electronics device which we use for the computation purpose or some documentation purpose. So they also connected to the gateway, right? So gateway, so that will be central part of the house. And also there is a energy harvesting, maybe power utilization or power water saving, energy harvesting, maybe solar or some green power generation. Those also are going to be solar power from the wind. So that also going to be. After studying that layout, let me see the complete picture of the house. So there is a movement sensor at the garage, car garage. In front of the house, there is a garage. So that car moving of sensors will be there. And we have, that is a energy monitor, the other side of the parking area of that house. There is a wall plug will be there. So, and also in the first floor, we can see there is a camera system. So LED bulb will be there. So that will be occupancy sensors. So that presence of humans here, that based on the temperature, you will decide that is. So setup box will be there. Setup box and LED bulbs will be there. And also there is a wall switch will be there. Wall switch. Then the biometric scale will be there. And also wireless radiator, thermostat will be there. Measure the temperature. And we have one more that, so that is a metro station connected to all this is interface with the real world, other world of the other part of the city. So that is one example. So continuation of that, energy efficiency at home is a important application, that possibility of the monetary saving for the consumer. So occupancy sensors, as we can be used to establish whether there is somebody in the room or not. When the room becomes unoccupied, temperature will be changes. So based on the temperature, that sensors will measure the temperature and transmit there, so that electrical signals will understand if somebody is there in the room or not. So lights are automatically switched off. So M2M system allows reducing energy consumption, automatically adapting the use of the house equipments to various short-term situations. So long-term situations, so when that resident people may not be there, so maybe go for vacation, in that case also, so power consumption will be taken care. So that after this smart home, that is a smart cards, that is a general. And this again M2M based system, in particular enable wired and wireless communication for the large set of commercial industrial applications. So here the purpose of the smart card is a safeguard user identities and their information, password, to perform requisite cryptographic computations, that is a tamper resistance devices. Card technology, contact or contactless possible. So terminal is the entity with which smart card can evolve a secure channel. Example, that generic card acceptance device, a CAD on a mobile handset, setup box, laptop, PC, so on that. So they need authentication to use up them. So one typical diagram of the card on the both side. So there is a user interface, secure terminal environment including keypad and display. At the bottom we have that UICC, that is a universal integrated circuit card with appliances. We have a small chip there. So that chip contains the firewall applications, USIM, the card acceptance device, right? So card acceptance or rejectance device will be there. So based on their pre-food that data, it can be. So different way of diagrammically represent that smart card, which contains the small chip there, which will be have some information of that customer, service provider, and all those. So there is also the typical model. We can see that card contact will be there. C1, C2, C3, C8 pins are there. C1 supply, power supply. So no connect. That is a clock will be there. No connect. And ground will be there, ground C5, and IO device, and so on. That is so that card contacts, and we have C1, C2, C3. That is a power supply, reset, clock, ground, input output device can be visualized here. So also you can understand that SIM of the most of the pin. That is a variety of SIMs may be possible. That is also smart card. And also the one more diagram you can see that control pad, that is a ATM debit or credit card, card chip will be there, right? So here stay with the antenna, right? So that is a plastic card layer, plastic card rail, three layers will be there. So there are a variety of cards. One such examples we have displaying here. So the smart card extended applications, we can enormous applications are there. Few of them listed here. There is a monitoring required card, vending machines, that chocolate vending machine, coffee vending machine, weighing machines. So those are all vending machines also need some card or some identity required. Security systems, and most of the lathe are industrial machines, AutoCADs, so on that, automotive. Traffic management, of course, we seen in the previous discussion. Speed cameras, so measure the speed of the vehicle at junction or at the accident point or the very turning roads wherever that accident spots are there. Medical equipments, of course, cyber security, enterprise ID, government utilization, the passport system, and various other examples. Are quite possible. That list may not be limited to that. Is also healthcare, identity, logical access, right? So that payment, point of sale may be observed in a bank or post office, right? Contactless payments, so that EMV payments, right? RFID, RFID tags, and security of these documents, government document, transportation, that to toll collections, or measure the speed and fine that the corresponding customer. So after discussing most of the things in this session, so let we summarize them, things we have to discuss. So we have started with the continuation of the session 2, that especially dedicated to the applications for this IoT concept. So that city automation, we have seen that city automation, that especially we have seen that road connection, hospital connection, industry connection, right? So and all those most of the components which will be become part of the city, so those are all become smart by connecting this IoT components. So automotive world, we have seen that public transport vehicle. And that especially we have seen that three cases, case 1, case 2, case 3, public transport vehicle, and traffic signal, and that fleet management, and city light, and all those. So home automation, of course, we have seen in length of various examples, that we have studied that layout, and also various examples we discussed, that first floor, second floor, and ground floor. There we have seen the various devices which are established to make a home smart. The smart cards also in the most of the today's world, most of the today's business, the customer and service provider, they can have very easy path and very sophisticated path for the customer as well as service provider without losing their profit, or they will voluntarily they will provide a service for the customer. So that can be helpful us. So here this material we have drawn from the textbook. So of course course, that is a Cisco Press, that is an Indian reprint. That is IoT fundamentals networking technologies. It increases the protocols and use cases for the Internet of Things by four other, that Haynes, Salgurio, Grass TT, Watu, and Henry. So, of course, it is a first edition which is available in most of the shops. That is entire syllabus covered there. And second book, of course, that is dedicated for Model 5, Internet of Things, that Srinivas KG, Singh is Learning India. Of course, reference books are there, Madhusetti and Bhaga, Internet of Things, Hands-on Approach, first edition, it is also available. And Rajkamal book, of course, is most of the practical case studies are elaborated, Internet of Things, Architecture and Design Principles, first edition, McRail 1. So, thank you for patient listening and shown an interest on IoT applications. Continuation of the introduction, IoT application is session 3, right? With session 2 also covered some applications. So, extended, a more elaborate way, the other examples covered in session 3. Thanks to coordinator, moderator and subject expert. Thank you.